Stop.
Dear Colleen, we were supposed to get together today, but I never called you back. It's been 6 years. I know it was stupid and inconsiderate of me not to call you, because you're the one on welfare raising a kid and trying to finish school. But I want you to know this was done on purpose. Despite the fact that all I do is think of you, every time I get together with you, you make my life total shit. I don't live in Glen Cove anymore either. I moved to New York City just to be with people of my own kind. You know, the ones who smoke a lot and drink coffee until they have chronic diarrhea. The city is alive and exciting. People get killed in front of me all the time. I step over homeless people and whistle my latest favorite song. They're building a building next to my building, and while tearing down the old one, asbestos clouds fill the air. I breathe in deeply and proudly blow out the fumes. Colleen, we're living in a world that's falling apart. And our present historians have the nerve to call it modern. Well, I have a good story for you, Mr. Historian. A teenager who took crystal meth no longer has a face. He ripped it off with a sharp edge of a mirror and later fed it to his pet dog. Colleen, does this signify anything to you? Who wants to live in a world filled with pre-adults who hate themselves so much that when they see their faces in the mirror, they rip them off? Adolescents of yesteryear made out of drive-in movie theaters and shared fribbles with the same straw. Today's high school students swallow whole bottles of Benadryl and call their boyfriends from the hospital, insisting that it's all their fault. I wrote a story about you. This one is funny, sad, and it flows. And if it's as good as I think it is, you might want to have me arrested. Colleen laughed so hard she was spitting in my face. I had to wipe the black phlegm off my face, so I stuck my tongue out. She tried to bite it off. I hate you, Colleen. I love you. I'm sick of driving you to AA meetings. Besides, I don't even have a license yet. This all took place at her friend Stacy's house. It was my 18th birthday present. She was going to fuck me whether I liked it or not. Truthfully, I didn't like it. I didn't like her. I didn't like the fact there were 25 other teenagers, all they could watch. I didn't like the two 11-year-olds wearing pajamas and drinking beer, or the parents downstairs watching TV and drinking hot cocoa. I wanted her. I needed her. And my family psychologist said I ought to pick another racehorse. Colleen was bound to lose. She brought me into a bedroom that smelled of manure. Her best friend Stacy was so strung out she didn't even know enough to do it in the bathroom. So her shit piled up beneath her dirty clothes. The parents never said anything. As a matter of fact, I don't think they ever saw her room. She pulled out a pair of horse clippers. What are you doing? Her hair falls off in clumps. It squirmed on the floor. I swear her hair follicles were screaming. She was bald. I had a deep desire to lick her hair. Suck her scalp clean. She was ivory to me. Too bad she hardly bathed. Where was this night going besides the local rehab center? What happened to the good old days shopping at the mall and grabbing a burger before we catch the bus back home? Now it's fuck, fuck, fuck. Get drunk and rock and roll. What happens if you don't like rock and roll? What happens if you like Line FM? All right, I confess. I like The Sound of Music. It's my favorite album in the whole wide world. Suddenly, she laughed again. It was forced, but I laughed too. She punched me in the stomach and I fell over in pain. She proceeded to climb on top of me and bite my neck. I smelled a funny smell. It rolled from her lips, down the side of my face, and onto my chin. Was it puke or alcohol? She ripped my shirt down the back. It was Banana Republic. My grandmother would be angry. I socked her in the head. Surprisingly, it put her in a better mood. Colleen, what are you doing to me? You feel like Barbie. I've only practiced on Ken. Man, what are you doing? Why are you licking my thing? It's not a lollipop. It's as sour as a pickle, and it's sensitive too.
Colleen, wait a minute, wait. Don't step away, I'm enjoying this.
Oh, I see. You have to throw up. Her freckles sparkled under all the lighters our friends were holding up. It looked like a concert. All the big-haired headbangers began to chant. The 11-year-olds chanted too. Fuck her, fuck her, fuck her up the ass, dude. And when you're done, send her over to me. The two 11-year-old girls must have been awfully confused by this. They thought Colleen and I were brother and sister all this time. The bedroom lights went back on. The teenagers held up scorecards. Not bad for my first performance. Oh God, I have a headache. I wish I were back home, watching TV in my Superman underoos. Everyone stops cheering, and the two little girls finish wiping me off. Colleen starts to thrash. She lets out a primal scream. Her arms and legs thrash and thrash and thrash in the air at somebody who just wasn't there. It's 6 years later, and I still can't finish the story. It will continue if and when I ever stop throwing up. By the way, Colleen, who were you thrashing at that night? I know it wasn't me. Was it God? I'm sure you know. He isn't going to do anything. His specialty is only making people nuts. Love always, Andy.
A fantasy, laughing at the sunrise like he's been up all night. Ooh, slipping and sliding, what a good time, but now have to find a bed that can take this weight.